There's simply no better sound than a garden alive with the industrious buzz of bees. Us gardeners owe a lot to these hard-working pollinators. Without them, we simply wouldn't be able to grow many of the fruits and vegetables that we take for granted. In this video, we look at a few simple but highly effective ways of attracting these essential insects.
In many parts of the world, bees and other pollinators, such as butterflies, are in decline. The reasons are complex, but include modern agricultural techniques, the spread of towns and cities, and the loss of natural habitat, such as wildflower meadows. No wonder bees are having a hard time. Bees provide a vital service by pollinating the plants that produce much of the food that we eat. They also pollinate the wildflowers that feed the insects that fuel the food chain. By helping bees, we're helping wildlife and ourselves. Combined, our gardens make up a vast area of green space. In towns and cities, they provide corridors of plant life for urban wildlife. By creating bee-friendly spaces within our gardens, we can help to support vulnerable populations while enjoying better harvests. Bee-friendly flowers draw in pollinators, putting your garden firmly on their map. Plan for a succession of flowers, so as one finishes, another starts off. By providing a constant supply of pollen and nectar for bees to feed on, you'll keep bees on site year-round. There are no hard and fast rules about what to plant, but opt for flowers rich in pollen and nectar. This usually means choosing single flowers over double flowers. A wide range of flowers, including many trees and shrubs, will serve as a bigger banquet for your bees. Plants that bloom early in the year offer food for bees emerging from hibernation. Suitable plants include willows, hawthorn, the blossom of fruit trees such as apples, cherries and plums, and plants such as crocus and aubretia. Excellent summer bloomers include clover, calendula, borage and the appropriately named poached eggplant. Towards the end of the year, make sure there are late season flowers available, such as aster, echinacea and common ivy. These are just some of the many bee-friendly flowers available. Most bee-friendly flowers prefer a sunny, sheltered location. Set plants in blocks or swathes to maximise their useful impact for bees. Our garden planner includes a selection of flowers proven to attract beneficial insects to your plot. Simply click on flowers or herbs in the selection bar drop-down filter to list some popular options. Clicking on the information button reveals the plant's description, including its suitability for attracting pollinators. Include flowers within your fruit and vegetable plot, either to the margins, at the ends of beds, or among crops as companion plants. Remember that flowering vegetables such as beans will also attract bees. Use the garden planner to select and drop flowers into place on your plan, or hold down the mouse to drag out a row, making them an integral part of your cropping plan. Allowing some corners of your garden to go a little wild will provide valuable habitat for bees. For example, in winter leave grass to grow longer and the hollow stems of perennials uncut to offer additional shelter. Many wild plants such as dandelions and thistles are a rich source of nectar and pollen, while the likes of nettles and brambles provide food for the larvae of pollinating butterflies. Cutting lawns less frequently also enables low-growing lawn flowers such as clover and daisies to flower for longer, which means more foraging opportunities for bees. Apply this hands-off approach to your entire lawn or specific areas. Wild bees nest in a range of locations, including small holes left by other animals, in sheltered nooks and crannies such as within a compost heap, or among thick tufts of grass. Stay vigilant and avoid disturbing nests or hibernation sites. Put up your own bee hotels to provide additional habitat for many types of solitary and bumblebee. You can make your own by gathering bundles of hollow stems, canes and twigs, and packing them into a watertight outer casing. Or drill different size holes into a block of untreated wood, between 2mm and 10mm, or 1/10 to 1/2 inch across. Position bee hotels in sheltered locations, away from the worst of the winter weather. Gardeners in tune with nature really shouldn't have to use chemical pesticides or weed killers. These unnatural controls both directly and indirectly impact beneficial wildlife, disrupting the food chain, depleting populations of pollinators and pest predators as well as pests, and thereby locking the gardener into a dependency on further chemicals. Instead, opt for natural pest controls, including netting, fleece or mesh barriers and companion plants, and opt for natural weed controls, such as mulches and regular hoeing.
Gardeners love bees. They're our hard-working allies, and without them we'd face very disappointing harvests. How do you attract bees to your garden? Tell us by dropping us a comment below. And if you found this video useful, be sure to subscribe to enjoy lots more gardening advice to help you through the growing season.